Greetings. This video did not go the way I envisioned. Thank you, brother, for the list of verses. They are a great encouragement to me. Exodus 3:15. Again, God said to Moses, "This is what you must say to the people of Israel. The Lord, Yahweh, God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name forever. This is my title throughout every generation. Glory to Yahweh, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob." Exodus 3:6. Moreover, he said, "I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob." And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God. Genesis 24:12. And he said, "O Lord, Yahweh, God of my master Abraham, I pray you, send me good speed this day, and show kindness unto my master Abraham. Let there be no mistake." Exodus 6:2. And God, Elohim, spoke unto Moses, and said unto him, "I am the Lord, Yahweh." Could God be any clearer? Exodus 15:3. The Lord, Yahweh, is a warrior. Yahweh is his name. Almighty God knows his own name. Exodus 15:3. The Lord Yahweh is a warrior. Yahweh is his name. So Prophet Moses knew the name of Yahweh. In these last days, I believe there will come a move to forget the name of God. Think about how C.S. Lewis presented it in the Narnia series. The Calamines are, of course, an image of a false religion. They worship Tash. The Narnians worship Aslan, the lion. And in one of the books, the names are merged as part of a deception. Tashlan. In the last days, beware of a movement for unity over truth. Love the truth. Love God. And remember his name, Yahweh. Make no mistake, you will be persecuted for his name's sake. Isaiah 66:5, "Hear the word of the Lord, Yahweh, you that tremble at his word. Your brethren that hated you, that cast you out for my name's sake, said, Let the Lord be glorified. But he shall appear to your joy, and they shall be ashamed." So Prophet Isaiah knew the name of Yahweh. Psalms 102:12, "But you, O Lord, Yahweh, abide forever, and your name is to all generations." Remember his name. Cry out to him. Psalm 32, "Lord, Yahweh, my God, I cried to you for help, and you healed me." Notice what Prophet David said, "Yahweh, my God." So Prophet David knew the name of Yahweh. God is but a title. Yahweh is his name. Do not substitute another word for God for the name of the one true God. Do not partake in the deception. Do not fall prey to the schemes of Al-Makr, the best schemer. When you hear, and you will begin to hear, let's call God Allah. Allah is just another word for God. Do not accept the lie, the deception. Psalms 102:12, "But you, O Lord, Yahweh, abide forever, and your name to all generations." The name Yahweh abides forever to all generations. Yahweh is his name. Not Thor, not Zeus, not Baal, not Shiva, and not Allah. Yahweh is his name. And when they call for compromise, smile and say, "Certainly, compromise is good." Tell them to demonstrate their submission to compromise. Ask them to compromise. Demand of them to worship Yahweh instead of the word Allah. Remind them, it's only a word for God. You will see they are not willing to compromise, and then stand firm and hold on to the name of Yahweh. Remember His name. Psalm 135:1, praise the Lord, praise the name of the Lord, praise Him, O servants of the Lord. And again, praise Yah, praise the name of Yahweh, praise Him, O servants of Yahweh. And there, just on the ground, a nugget of gold. Psalm 135:1, praise the Lord. Or in the Hebrew, I'm looking at Bible Hub, praise you the Lord. And in the Hebrew, hallelujah, hallelujah, praise the Lord, hallel to Yah. I've known this concept for years, but to see in one place the clear Hebrew, I'm excited. This confirms that Didat was foolishly wrong to claim hallelujah means Allah hey. Thank you, Lord. Glory to you, Yahweh. Hallelujah. Proverbs 18:10, the name of Yahweh is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and are protected. So Prophet Solomon knew the name of Yahweh. When you share the truth with someone from Islam, let them know. Prophet Moses knew the name of Yahweh. Prophet David knew the name of Yahweh. Prophet Solomon knew the name of Yahweh. Prophet Jeremiah knew the name of Yahweh. Jeremiah 33:2, thus says the Lord Yahweh, yet again there will be heard in this place of which you say. Prophet Hosea knew the name of Yahweh. Hosea 12:5, even the Lord Yahweh, the God of hosts, Yahweh is His name. Prophet Isaiah knew the name of Yahweh. Isaiah 26:8, yes, Yahweh, yes, Lord, we wait for you in the path of your judgments. Our desire is for your name and renown. Isaiah 42:8, I am Yahweh, that is my name. I will not give my glory to another, or my praise to idols. Wow, it is a late night, but God just keeps showing me stuff. I am Yahweh, that is my name. Will you just look at what else Yahweh said? I will not give my glory to another. Think about that for a moment. I will not give my glory to another. God will not share His glory with another. Another what? Another God. Another separate God. I will not give my glory to another. John 17:5. Now, Father, glorify me together with yourself, with the glory which I had with you before the world was. I will not give my glory to another. Glorify me together with yourself, with the glory which I had with you. I will not give my glory to another. With the glory which I had with you. Not to another. The glory which I had with you. Is it sinking in? Makes me want to shout. As if there were any doubt, Jesus is not a separate God. God said He would not share His glory with another. But clearly God had shared His glory with Jesus. Now, Father, glorify me together with yourself, with the glory which I had with you. Thanks, brother, for sharing this list of scriptures with me. You've blessed my heart, and God has flowed through you. Hold fast, brothers and sisters, and look up, for our redemption draws near. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.